Hey guys, welcome to today's plumberparts.co.uk video.
Ever thought there was an easier way to do the pipework underneath your kitchen sink? Well, today I'm going to be showing you a new way to do it. Look at it, most of the pipework we're not going to have to do down on our knees with a bent over back. So watch all of this video to find out how I piped up underneath this kitchen sink. Remember to subscribe and hit the notification as well, and come back next week because I'll be showing you how to turn the water on and off from your mobile phone.
There's going to be a song at the end of it, there always is, suggested by my lovely patrons over at the Ale Army live stream that happens on Thursday evenings at 7 p.m. If you want to get involved in that, click on the links below. So, I hope you enjoyed today's video, guys. Hit the subscribe button, hit the like. It's going to be a good one today. And remember to hold tight. Let's get going. So guys, what is the problem here? Why am I trying to figure out another way of doing this particular task? Well, it's because I often find that when you go to the pipework underneath the kitchen sink, it's been done quickly without any regard for the people who are going to use it in the future, without any regard of how they're going to turn the water off. And also, there's a cupboard under here that they should be allowed to use. And if you're whacking up pipes straight through the middle, then that really annoys those people. The other reason that I'm going to do this is because I actually want to make this side of the job easier. It's not a lot of fun getting under one of these worktops here with your blowtorch. The thing is, you can get the old sink here, this beautiful sink that I've got, which is probably worth about a tenner, and is flibbity flobbity. You can burn them, you can warp them, you can do loads of stuff with that hot heat underneath. And also, I want to make it so you're not bent over all the time. I mean, look, there is going to be a part of this job where you're bent over doing this sort of work, but that's just how it is. So look, without further ado, the first thing you're going to do is this. You're going to measure out from the back, leaving a couple of inches from there to the back. You're going to measure from a little bit off the bottom up to a little bit off the top, and you're going to get yourself a nice bit of plywood. That's the first thing you're going to do. The second thing you're going to want to do is when you've got this carcass and everything here, or when it's out, try and make sure that the cold feed in, the cold mains in, comes in at the front to one side of that carcass. If that means you've got to do a little bit of pipe work underneath the kickboard here, then do it, okay? Don't say, oh, I'm not going to do it because I can't be bothered. That's not the attitude, is it? You're going to want to make it easier for your customer, or if it's in your own home, you're going to want to make it easier for yourself. So take 20 minutes, half an hour, just to make sure that, I mean, it's probably going to be in 25mm MDPE or whatever. If it's in copper, do it in hard copper. Get it over to the right place. If it's coming up in the middle, then it's pointless, this job. So make sure it comes up at the front to one side or the other, because we can do this on this side, we can do it on that side, but we're going to use that side panel to start off with. It's important that we do that, and you'll find out why in a minute. So I'm just going to cut my bit of wood up. We're going to take these two out here, and we're going to have a look at getting this installed now.
By the way, guys, all the tools I use in this video, including this very snazzy workbench, are available in my Amazon store. Links are below.
Right, so there we go, got a bit of wood, let's get on with the job.
Gesundheit!
There's our bit of wood now, that fits in nicely in there. So now we can pop that to the back like so. How about that, that's looking really good. We can mark that hole there, the centre of that hole, the centre of this hole, and the centre of this hole. So now I know that that's going to be my cold mains water in, that's going to be my softened cold out to the house, and that's also going to be my hot supply back in from the house. And that's kind of the standard sort of thing you're going to have going on here. There might be a few other little pipes, bits and pieces, like, I don't know, a pipe to an outdoor tap, that sort of thing. But now, you see, you've got the template here, you know, straight away already. And you can write down on this if you want. How about you write down on it? Cold water main in.
Cold soft out, and then hot in.
And then you've got them there already. Next thing you just want to take note of as well, if we put a clip on here, so that's going to bring our pipe out just a little bit further than that. So what we might have to do when we do our pipe work in a minute is just pop a little set on there, and then we know that our pipes and everything go in okay. Now, I know, for instance, that sometimes you're going to have a pipe sticking up here already. That means that maybe you're going to have to put your clip a little bit further up so you've got room to put a little set in before that clip. Pipe work's pipe work. Practice. So now I can go up on my worktop and design this system out. First thing I'm going to do on this one here is just measure out 6.2, something like that there. Now I can put a nice line in all the way up. Know then that our pipe's going to be coming up there.
So I hope you're already realising the beauty of doing the job this way. Not only can you do everything on a bench, not bent down with your back hurting and all the rest of it, banging your head, or the customer's dog salivating all over you and wanting to bite your head off, but also you can lay out the system, design it nicely, make your pipework nice and straight. Plus, you can make changes to the pipework layout after you've planned it out, which you'll see later on in this video.
So, let's lay out what I actually want, because we're going to do a fairly complicated install here, because what we're going to have is a water softener on this system. So we're going to make this so we've got our water softener manifold on here as well. Usually this pipework would be fairly dirty, but we're going to make it so it's nice and clean. So let's do that now. I want my stop tap fairly close to that front door. Straight after that, we're going to have my drain off. And then what I tend to do is just leave quite a lot of pipe here. The reason for that is because you know, afterwards someone might want to add something. And then that gives them a nice area there to cut into it. That's the simple reason. So now let's plan out my manifold. I know that I'm going to want a T here and an elbow there. I know I'm definitely going to want an elbow here in a minute and an elbow here.
So the key considerations when installing a softened water manifold is to firstly have an unsoftened water supply going up to your kitchen tap, but also we need to make sure that if anything goes wrong with the water softener or it needs to be serviced, then we have a manifold for the water softener that we've built for that purpose.
So here it is, all planned out. We've got our cold water main in, we've got our drain off, we've got a clip, then we've got a nice area here. Anyone wants to add anything to this, then they'll be able to. Our cold water then can go up and just go straight into our tap unsoftened, or it can come through into our water softener, back out again, and then off to our cold water system. If our water softener goes wrong, we can turn that valve off, and open that valve, and still supply the rest of the house. And then simply, we've got our hot water up here. So now all I've got to do is build it. And you guys know how much fun that's gonna be, because it is gonna be fun. Much more fun building it up here on a proper piece of wood than it is building it under there. Already you're seeing that we can now do this all in front of us and get this done properly. So let's get on with it.
So as you can see, we've got the essentials on the table there, a fluctuator, absolutely fantastic tool, some wire wool, and all the little bits and pieces that you need to do this job. Oh, I do love doing a bit of soldering.
Right then, so we've got to put a lovely couple of little sets in here, and then we're done. I mean, that whole manifold is done, all above ground, if you know what I mean. Just made a little mark on there, pop that on the side of the former here. Hell yeah, I miss it. Like so. Then we're gonna put ourselves a little one to there. And then go and spoil it all by saying something stupid like, I love you. In the words of David Bowie, Yoses, that was a whiz.
So apparently the language is originally a lot, more swear words.
Yeah.
And that belt around his neck. Yeah. He wants to try and stop it, he tries to reach it.
By the way, guys, the podcast I'm listening to is the Cinephiles podcast. It's amazing. So if you ever get a chance, listen to it, the Cinephiles podcast. They just review a whole film, and today's episode is that hilarious comedy, Deliverance. Anyway, this is going really, really well. I'm just going to get my last bend set done, get my last little elbow up, get my valves tightened on and popped in, and then we're ready to pop it up inside. It's going to look wicked. We'll be right back. Oh, guys, look at it. It's looking really, really good. Love my tote bag. I'll do a little lineup at the end of this video of all the stuff that I've used in it. And I couldn't find my usual blue roll, so I've got to use a bit of toilet roll. But now, of course, the creme de menthe. A little bit of Brasso, make it look beautiful. That's what it's all about. And the good thing is because I haven't closed my clips yet, I can just lift out each piece, just like this. Give it a good old clean. Right then guys, it's done, so let's see what it looks like when it's in there. So look at that, all built up in one piece. We've got our manifold for our water softener there, it's all here. Now there's another little thing about this that's really, really handy. If we need to take any of this pipework out to work on it, all we need to do is turn that off, that off, that off, that off, and then turn the mains off outside, and you can pull this whole manifold out. I mean, how easy is that? Right, so look, I've just got to guide it into there, guide it into that first hole. Look at that, how neat is that? And then you can just pop a screw up here. Obviously you're gonna have to reach underneath the carcass to do your final connections, and that's probably the hardest bit of doing this job. Often you'll find there's gonna be a bit of push fit under there, or you're gonna have to do one solder, or it's gonna be a compression fitting. But that little bit of work you're gonna have to still do sometime or other, with or without my method. On there, that'll be our hot feed coming back from the tank or the boiler or wherever it may be. So I'm really, really pleased with that. I like this way of doing it. As you get older, that sort of way is a lot more preferable. I had my radio on, I was listening to my podcast about deliverance, and you know, everything was in front of me. I could clean the pipework nicely. I could make sure that it all works okay. Also, now I know that when someone comes here, I mean, I know that this is all getting knocked down, but when someone comes to the house, they'll be able to drain down the system easily from there. They'll be able to shut it down easily as well from there. That's not hidden at the back or anything like that. I mean, I could, if there was enough room to the door, I'd actually twist that round facing this way, you know, and it's easy to do, just slacken them two off and bring it round and do it. But that's the way I'm gonna do all these from now on. Get that last one shut, come on, Jimmy. Like that, it's just really, really good, really rigid. So I hope you've enjoyed this little video. It's not an instructional video. I know I do all the videos that I do on plumber parts, there's so many different types, and this one is more just an appraisal for yourself, maybe. Have a little think about how you do something and improve it. And I tell you what, if you've got something out there that you do every day or you do often and you've thought of a different way of doing it, a way to improve it, then comment below. It'd be really, really good to see. And I am going to now go and have a beer. I feel like I've earned a beer. It's gone 6 o'clock now in the studio, so I think that's beer time, don't you? Thanks ever so much for watching today, guys. I hope you've enjoyed watching today's video. I hope you've learned something. I hope you've enjoyed the music, because there's going to be some great music in a minute that I always record a little song, don't I? And remember, there's one thing you've got to do. If it's not subscribe, if it's not hit like, comment below and all those things, which you should have done anyway, and hit the bell to get a notification. It's of course, I think we know what it is. That's the hold time. See you soon. Can I do my best hold time? Hold time. Hold time for the bad boy. Bruh.
Don't do your back here, baby.
No. You don't want to do your back here, bro.
Don't do your back here.
That's not the last thing on the list,
baby.
So film it now, guys. Film it.
It's time to get this right on right now. It's time to get that out of the front now. Oh, we don't want to do our back here right now.
So let's do some pipework, baby. Oh yeah.
I was wondering now what I'm doing this for. I'm always on my knees down off the floor. Getting slapped down by the customers, Rottweiler. Gotta change my pipework, baby. Gotta up my pipework, baby. Yeah.
It's simple when you think about it, baby. You do this all your life and you'll have fuck knees.
You'll have fuck knees.
And the apprentice is the police who try to disagree. It's never much fun when the staff has sees.
Yeah.
So try to do the pipework the best way that you can.
Oh, you know it feels good, baby, when you're sitting back. And now when there's problems, everything can be reached. That's the thing that I wanna teach.
Yes, you wanna touch her, baby. So when the customer gets home from a hard day, they're gonna look under the sink, then they're gonna say, oh my god, brother, what you done there? Looks proper nice, looks proper shiny. The pipework proves that you had a prophecy, because I can turn the water off in an emergency. Shit, that is like, blown my brains, bruv.
This song was selected by my friends at the ALME. They did it on a Thursday night because they were there for the live stream. I drank a beer and they got some video sneak peek. So click on the link and make sure to subscribe, because it's like an orgasm on your finger.
And remember to hit that notification button for every time I upload a new video. And also, you can find all of our stuff in our Amazon store. And lastly, remember to follow my vlog over at Times of Jed. Oh my god, I'll see you in the next video, guys. I love you very much. Bye-bye!